full injunction against the unused PDAF remain in effect until final resolution by the Honorable Court. The provisional remedy of a TRO is issued to protect the rights of the applicant suffering grave and irreparable injury due to the acts of the respondents. Out of the 24.7 billion allocated for the PDAF under the 2013 GAA, only 11.6 billion have been released according to the Department of Budget and Management. Hence, approximately 13.19 billion remains to be released. Petitioners and even other taxpayers have a clear legal right to enjoin unlawful expenditure of such huge sums of public funds and prevent its dissipation. The people, the state, will suffer grave and irreparable injury if the TRO is lifted, as billions of pesos will be unconstitutionally dissipated if the remaining PDAF is released. Further, the Solicitor General's plea to release the PDAF to help the identified scholars and indigent patients is inconsistent with his admission that the President has already committed to withholding of the remaining funds. This means that the PDAF, as a solution to these problems, is no longer on the table. Public respondents are not without power to act on the pleas of the scholars and indigent patients. Congress can pass a law, a Special Appropriations Act, to supplement the General Appropriations Act. The Executive is authorized to augment items in the General Appropriations Act from savings. Local government units are authorized to pass supplemental budgets under the local government code. How these problems will be addressed by the legislative or executive branches is a question of policy, but certainly it does not lie with the lifting of the Honorable Court's TRO. Petitioners are not insensitive to the needs of our countrymen who have relied on the PDAF. Nevertheless, any public solution to alleviate their suffering must be derived from a process sanctioned under our democratic framework and not through any unconstitutional means. In Birago versus the Philippine Truth Commission, the Honorable Court held, and I quote, "No matter how noble and worthy of admiration the purpose of an act, but if the means to be employed in accomplishing it is simply irreconcilable with constitutional parameters, then it cannot still be allowed," end quote. One cannot help but sympathize with the plight of those who have relied on the PDAF for their educational and health needs. Indeed, the park bio system may have become so ingrained in the national consciousness that some of us may have learned to forgive the excesses of congressional largesse for as long as they can depend on elected officials for dole outs, for tuition fees, and hospital expenses. It is time that our country breaks away from this system of dependency, which has, contrary to its avowed purpose, not even significantly contributed to the development of the poorest regions of our nation. At this point in time, there is nothing more pressing than the abolition of this unconstitutional mechanism of a pork barrel system. In doing so, the Honorable Court shall help ensure the sanctity of properly appropriating national funds for the greater public good, and not for any individual private gain. We submit, Your Honors.
Thank you, Attorney D. And Attorney Alcantara, you proceed, please.
Good afternoon, Your Honors. Petitioners Greco Belhica, Jose Villegas Jr., Jose L. Gonzalez, Reuben M. Abante, Quintin Paredes San Diego, Pedrito Nepomuceno, and yours truly, Your Honor, Samson Alcantara, wish to express their eternal gratitude to this Honorable Court